Hi, good evening. Nana here. Release 13 of Fusion has got plenty of enhancements, and then especially in procurement side, there are more than even 300 enhancements actually. So in this video, we are going to see about how to create a procure to pay reporting. Fine. And then in Release 13, and then there has been much simplified, and then what happens, it has been much coordinated, and then it is very easy to use. And then those who don't know even how to create an OTBI report can also learn from this video actually. So let us go there and then have a look at it now. Fine. So let us now have a look at it first of all. So let me share my screen now.
Hello, my name is Manamagan. Welcome to training for Oracle Purchasing Cloud in Oracle Procurement Cloud. In this session, we talk about generating reports using the Procure to Pay subject area in Oracle Purchasing Cloud. For the capabilities covered in this training, we explain what they do, followed by more detail to explain how you can use them and what business value they bring. Then we walk you through a demonstration. Next, we explain what you need to consider before enabling these features in your business and what you need to know to set them up. A new subject area called Procure to Pay Real-Time has been added to Procurement's Oracle Transactional Business Intelligence or OTBI. You can use this subject area to create your own ad hoc reporting and analysis on Procure to Pay data. The Procure to Pay subject area contains real-time data on requisitions, purchase orders, receipts, and invoice, and also additional dimensions that are critical for the procurement process. It allows procure to pay reporting using metrics, attributes, and dimensions for requisitions, purchase orders, invoice, and receipts. This helps the organization to slice and dice the procure to pay data. With single subject area, buying organizations can now analyze data patterns and trends which can be used to drive decisions to monitor and improve the procurement process. The Procure to Pay OTBA subject area provides direct access to Procure to Pay information to make critical decisions. The report and analysis will help you understand the spend history better, leading to improved productivity and accuracy. Procurement managers and buyers can use the metric-based reports to assess procurement spend. It also improves the visibility in the entire procurement process, thereby helping the user to identify bottlenecks, inefficiencies, and to address them. Users can leverage the comprehensive set of procurement attributes and the available metrics to create complex reports that meet a wide variety of real-time procure-to-pay requirements. In addition, it also improves collaboration between the stakeholders and overall business effectiveness. The improved collaboration also results in better utilization of resources and consistency in terms of what data to monitor, which metrics to establish, and how to measure the progress. Now, let's go to a demo that will show you how the feature can be used by your business. All right, let me walk you through the steps to create a report. So, go to the Reports and Analytics and click here in the drop-down and find this analysis. Click on the analysis, it will open up all the subject areas. So here, you can find this procure to pay real time. This is the subject area which we have added newly. So I try to select this. All right, let me collapse this. You can find here the subject area, procurement procure to pay real time. There you can find all the dimensions, attributes, and measures. Now I'll walk you through how to create a simple report. So I'll start with the supplier. So I'd like to add supplier also one of the column. That has been added. So now I'll select purchase order. So to add a purchase order, go to the purchase order folder. Expand that. Look for order. Yeah, I find that. Order. Add it. And then let me add a requisition. I go to requisition folder. And I have this requisition number. Try to add that. Then let me add a invoice and receipts. So to add it, go to the invoice folder, wherein you can, you'll find invoice as well as the receipt. All right. So now what we did is we went to the Procure to Pay subject area, and we have seen all the dimensions, attributes, measures, what are all available, and what is required for this particular report. We have selected those columns. That is what has been shown over here. And then I click on next. So you're landing the select views page, wherein you can select a table. So for this report, I select table recommended as an option. So I'm clicking next. And you find this edit table page, wherein you can edit the table properties and layout. For this demo, I'm skipping this process. All right. So the next step is need to add the columns to sort it, and also you have to apply the filters. So I'm adding these columns so that it can be sorted. Then I'll add this filter. Let me add a filter which is not there in this list. Maybe a procurement view. Also, I'll add one more filter. As supplier. Okay, so let me give a value for this procurement view, association operations, and for the supplier, let me give a value as this. All right. So now I have given the columns to be sorted and also the filters, and then go to the next step. If needed, you can apply the conditional formatting to this table. I'm skipping this process for this report. All right. Now you need to come up with a name for this report. So let me say this is a procure to pay report. And give some description. Select a folder to save it. So I select drafts as a folder wherein this report will be saved. And then finally I'm submitting it. And getting a confirmation message stating that the report has been saved. It takes some few seconds to really reflect here. So let me go back to the navigator and try to select the same reports and analytics. Expand this pane. Going to the my folders and going to the subfolder drafts. You can find your report here, Procure to Pay report. So click on the report. It opens up your pop-up wherein you can see the view option. So click on the view option. It takes a few seconds. All right, you can see the report which got generated for the filtering criteria, requirement deviation operations, and the supplier as CV underscore sub A00. With the columns as supplier, order, requisition number, invoice, and receipt number. This concludes the demo. Here is some additional information regarding this enhancement. The procure to pay subject area is designed with a simplified folder structure to facilitate report creation. You can create your own custom reports using the available subject area folders. The procure to pay content enables users to slice and dice data based on shared common dimensions across requisitions, purchase orders, invoice, and receipts. This includes the ability for the customers to generate a report on spend for purchase orders, requisitions, invoice, and receipts, and also generate a report on invoices with or without matched purchase orders. In addition, you can also generate a report on requisitions that are associated with purchase orders. Finally, you can generate a report on purchase orders, pending receipts, and invoices based on open quantity and amount. The available measures include the ordered amount, invoice amount, purchase order price, invoice price variance, quantity delivered, and other important measures across procurement documents like the requisitions, purchase orders, invoice, and receipts. To give an example, the customer can generate a report to identify a list of purchase orders that are pending receipts with receipt date earlier than the current date. This will help the customers to take corrective actions and mitigate risk arising out of material delay. In this implementation advice section, we will go through what you need to consider before enabling this feature in your business and what you need to know to set them up. This feature is automatically available. It does not have an opt-in option. There is no setup associated with this feature. This feature can be accessed through any of the following shift job roles, like buyer, category manager, and procurement manager. The business processes that are affected by this feature are manage purchase orders, manage requisitions, manage inbound material management, and manage invoices. No seeded reports are provided with this feature. A sample procure-to-pay report has been shown here. The new BA subject area name is Procurement Procure-to-Pay Real-Time. Some of the notable dimensions to mention for this capability are purchase orders, invoices, suppliers, requisitions. This concludes this presentation. Thank you for listening. You can easily pause and rewind any of these slides if you require additional time to take in the detail.
So this concludes a very simple way of creating an OTBI report for a procure to pay lifecycle. And so what happens, this can be used even for other ones, right? Even though it is available only on release 13. The other features, you can make an experiment on, you can experiment it on you can make an experiment on the other features on release 12 itself. Fine. So that's a fine thing. So this will now teach you about how to create a OTBI report. And then what happens, you can become an expert. And then you can even have a summation and other things added up in the bottom. So there are so many other features which you can even think of. And then what happens, fine-tune your reporting capabilities. Fine. So best wishes to all of you for creating an excellent OTBI report as far as Fusion is concerned. So what happens, this idea has been thrown open to the functional consultants themselves. So they themselves can now create everything, whatever they want. Bye, and then best wishes. Thank you.